5's Leon Bibb spent the day in Chardon today.
Indeed, I did spend the day in Chardon. You know, it is a community trying to find its footing again. Understandably, there is an uneasiness there, but Chardon is pulling together. Its people are embracing each other, especially the children. But something more, in some ways, each one of us has a heart in Chardon. The old saying, time heals all wounds. The old clock in Chardon Square ticks, but ever so slowly. The wounds here are still fresh and will not leave. There are red ribbons everywhere, representing the red of the high school colors. It was violence at the high school which brought Chardon the heartache, which covers it so completely.
I went to elementary school with these kids. It's still surreal. It's still extreme. It's unreal.
Yes, it's hard, but everybody's doing it together.
And then it all kind of hits you again, so yeah. It is tough.
The Chardon High School red is a reminder to love the children. In this community, there is heavy weight. Violence claimed lives of 3 students and the woundings of 2 others. So at the gazebo, Chardon Center, perhaps its heart, candles flicker and the teddy bears of youth stare back. From nearby and farther away come people in pilgrimage to this special place.
It's like one family. We're all one community. I live in Bainbridge.
You're just kind of drawn to it, just to kind of give yourself some comfort, actually.
No matter where we live, we are all citizens of Chardon. The grief which is centered here has rippled out and has touched so many different places. Whether we are in Chardon or outside Chardon's city limits, we all hold hands and look for answers. In many ways, we're all citizens of Chardon. You're a youth director at a church. What do you tell the kids?
I tell them that God is stronger than all of this.
What happened here binds us together. It is the topic of talk wherever you go in Chardon. The violence which swept through here is never far away from any discussion. If time heals wounds, healing is so slow in coming. So Chardon waits and prays for the healing as the clock ticks slowly. The high school student at the gazebo said, teachers were helping the students get through all of this. For a long time, she stood prayerfully at the gazebo, gazing into the dancing flame of the candle. I did not ask her for what she prayed, but I knew, and probably so do you.